Good morning, dear students. As I told you that we are starting a small revision course for the NEET 2020 part affiliation. So yesterday I have been started with your units and dimensions. So today we'll try to continue with the same continuation of the topic, that is units and dimensions, and as well as of your errors part affiliation. So let us try to take the next question. So we are only trying to concentrate on the numericals, some of the good questions and numericals, so that it will be helpful for your competitive examinations. Let us try to take the question right now, the next question. In hypothetical experiment, a hypothetical experiment conducted to determine Young's modulus y is equals to your cos theta t to the power of your x into your tau divided by your L cube, where y is your Young's modulus, t is nothing but of your time. Y is your Young's modulus, capital T is equals to your time period, capital T is your time period, comma, tau is equals to torque, and L is equals to length. Then find the value of your x. This is a question. I'm giving the options for this one. First option is taken as of your 0, second option is 1, third option is 2, and fourth option is given as of your 3. See the question right now. From the given condition, we just need to calculate the value of your x part affiliation. Every other dimensions are also given for me for the given condition. See the clarity of that one, that will be giving you given condition. Now see here, an hypothetical experiment is conducted to determine the Young's modulus. Y value is given for me. So take some time right now, try to do it before you see the solution for this one. Cos theta is an exponent, what do you call that one? It's dimensionless quantity right now for the given condition. That means y is equals to t power of x into tau by L cap. That means here y must be equal to your t power of your x into tau by your L cube. T is your time period part affiliation I can write. So dimensions of t power of x will be equal to how much for me? So therefore t power of your x will be equal to your dimensions of your y into your L cube divided by your tau. Y is nothing but of your Young's modulus. The dimensions of that one is equals to how much for me? Your m L power minus 1 t power minus 2. I hope you remembered. Y is equals to stress by strain. Stress is force by area. So force by area. Force is ml t power minus 2 divided by area is L square. If I simplify it, we'll be getting m L power minus 1 t power minus of your 2 into your L is nothing but L. So this will become for me your L cube. This one is nothing but of your L cube divided by torque. Torque is equals to force into your displacement part affiliation. So dimensions of that one will become for me your m into your L square t power of your minus of your 2 part affiliation. Torque is equals what? Force into displacement or vertical. So tau is equals to your R into your F. R is nothing but of your L. F is equals to ml t power of your minus 2. So this will become for me ml square t power minus 2. So from this one, this m is getting cancelled right now for me. L power minus 1, L power cube will become for me L power 2. So this will become minus 2. So this will become this square, and this L will also get cancelled everywhere. T power minus 2, T power will also get cancelled. So this is coming out for me 0. This is coming out for me 0. That means if this is a 0, means X will be equal to how much for me? 0. This is nothing but of your M0, L0, T0. So dimension of your X must be equal to your 0 part affiliation. So the answer for this one is nothing but first option. So the hypothetical experiment conducted to determine the Young's modulus Y is equals to cos theta T power X into tau by your L cube. This one is nothing but of your L cube, beta. So this one is your L cube. Where y is Young's modulus, t is time period, t is nothing, tau is nothing but torque, and l is the length. Then find the value of your x is that thing. So simplify it with the help of your dimensions, we'll get the answer x is equals to your 0. I hope you are clear with this model. Okay, chalo. Let us try to take the next question right now related to this given condition part. Say for example, if I am taking one more question, so the question says right now for me something like this. The least count of the main scale, next question if I am taking right now, the least count of the main scale main scale of a screw gauge is 1 mm. The minimum number of divisions on its circular scale required to measure 5 micrometer diameter of a wire is dash. I'll give the option. First option is 50, second option is 200, third option is 500, and fourth option is given as of your 100. Pause the video for 1 minute and try to do it on your own before seeing the solutions part of relation. So I hope you might have been doing that one. So the least count of the main scale is given for me, beta. So how do you calculate in the screw gauge the least count? So least count is equals to measure of your one main scale division, that is nothing but of your 1 MSD, divided by number of divisions on your circular scale. Number of divisions on circular scale part of relation. So measure of one main scale division divided by number of divisions on your main or circular scale. This one is nothing but on beta, on circular scale. CS is nothing but what? A circular scale. Here minimum value to be measured, or the least count is given how much for me? Or 5 micrometer. So least count is given for me how much for me? 5 micrometer. That is 5 into 10 to the power of your minus 6 meter. That is equals to your 1 mm. So it is this nothing but of your 10 to the power of your minus 3 divided by number of divisions on a circular scale will be equal to your N. So N value will be equal to how much beta for me? N is equal to, if I'm taking this one, this is 10 to the power of minus 3 divided by 5 into 10 to the power of minus 6. So simplify it, this will become for me 1000, because this 3 and this will go right now. So this one and this one will be here minus 3. This will go up 1000. This will become for me 5. So it is 1000 by 5. That will become for me how much? 200 divisions. So this is nothing but of your 200 divisions. So second option is your correct answer for the given question. Clear for everyone? Sure. Let us try to go for the next question based upon this part of relation. The question is, I hope you might have been doing such type of questions from the long run also. Say for example, the question says right now for me something like this. The next question is, a vernier caliper has 1 mm mark on the main scale. It has 20 equal divisions on vernier scale, which match with 16 main scale divisions. For this vernier calipers, the least count is, this is a question right now for me. I'll give the options for this one. 0.02 mm. Second option is 0.05 mm. And third one is 0.1 mm. And fourth one is 0.2 mm. Okay, so try to see this question and try to do it out. See whether you can do it or not for the given question. Pause the video for a minute and try to do it on your own before you see the solution for this one. A vernier calipers has how much better? Let us try to do it out. A vernier calipers has 1 mm mark on the main scale. It has a 20 equal divisions on vernier scale, which matches with your 16 main scale divisions. That means I can write here 16 main scale divisions is equals to your 20 vernier scale division. That is nothing but 20 times of your VSD part of relation. Therefore, I can write 1SD will become for me how much better? 1 VSD will be equal to how much will be? 16 by 20, that will become for me 4 by 5. So, this one is 4 by 5 times of your main scale division. 1 vernier scale is equals to 4 by 5 main scale division. What is the least count formula beta? Least count is equals to your 1 main scale division minus of your 1 vernier scale division part of relation. Main scale division minus vernier scale division is your given condition. So, it is nothing but of your 1 MSD minus 1 VSD is how much for me? 4 by 5 MSD. That is equals to 1 minus of 4 by 5 MSD. Main scale divisions is the answer for that one. 1 minus of 4 by 5 into 1 main scale division is given how much for me? 1 mm in the given problem. So this is already given as of your 1 mm. So this one is nothing but of your 1 mm. Vernier scale has of your 1 mm mark on the main scale. So main scale division is equals to 1 mm. 1 minus of your 4 by 5 into 1. If you simplify it, we'll be getting approximately 0.2 mm. So this is your method to do the problem for the given condition part of relations. So I hope you are clear with this one. Next question, you write, beta. The question says that if 2x percentage be the percentage error in specific resistance, 2x be the percentage error in specific resistance given by rho is equals to pi r square into capital R by your L, where r is the radius having value of 0.2 plus or minus 0.01. R is the radius having the value 0.2 plus or minus 0.1 centimeters. R is the resistance of 60 plus or minus of your 3 ohm. 60 plus or minus of your ohm. And L is the length. L is the length of 150 plus or minus 1.5 centimeter. Find x. Come on, try to do it out. Pause the video for 1 minute and try to take the time and try to do it out. Direct question beta. If 2x be the percentage error in the specific resistance, this is the answer. We need to calculate the value of x. Rho is equal to pi r square into capital R by your L, where r is the radius having the value of 0.2 plus or minus 0.01 centimeter. R is the resistance 60 plus or minus 3 ohm. And L is the length of 150 plus or minus 1.5 centimeter. Find the value of your x part of relation. He is asking us to calculate the value of your x part of the relation, part of the condition. I hope you can do specific resistance. If I am writing in terms of error, delta rho by rho in terms of your percentage will be equal to pi is constant. So this one is nothing but 2 into delta R by your R. Plus this one is nothing but delta capital R by your R. Plus this one is nothing but of your delta L by your L. Everything is right now in the percentage error right now. So I am taking right now this one as into your percentage for everyone. So it is given in the problem as right now delta r by r is equal to how much for me? This is a 2 into, I am writing the delta r value. See in the data he has given me the value as of your 0.01 divided r value is nothing but equal to your 0.2. Plus this one is nothing but of your delta r value is nothing but a 3 by your 60 plus delta l value is nothing but of your 1.5 divided by your 150 part of relation. So if I am taking the conditions right now, if I multiply for this one, so this 2 is not for this one into, this 2 is only for this r, so this is nothing but of your 2 into your percentage error, that is nothing but equal to 100. Isn't it? Now simplify this one for the given condition. So this comes out for me 0.2 into 2. So that is 0.2. That will become for me 0.1 plus this one is nothing but of your 3 2s are. That is nothing but equal to 0.05 plus this will be 1.5 means 15 divided by 1500. If I take this one, 00 gets cancelled. So this comes out for me 0.001. 0.001 part of relation. Check the calculation of this one, 1.5 divided by 0. Yeah, so this will be 0.01 only. This will be 0.01 into your 100, part. Now simplify this one, 0.01 plus 0.01 plus 0.1 part of relation. If I'm simplifying for that one, that comes out for me 16%. That is nothing but of your 16%. So this is your answer. So delta rho by rho percentage will be equal to 16%. Answer is given how much for me? 2 times of your s. That means if I take for how much times it will become for me? 2 into 2, 8 is a 16. So that is nothing but 2 times of your x. So therefore x value will become for me how much for me? 8. If I keep the value of x is equal to 8, that will be the percentage error in the specific resistance. Clear for everyone? Okay.